Hey guys, welcome. It's good to see you guys here. Welcome back to another edition of In the Spotlight. Hope you guys are doing well. Alright, perfect. Hey guys, my name is Rohit and thank you for joining us for this week's edition of In the Spotlight. Today we'll be talking to one of the successful owners who's been part of the business for more than a decade now. And he's going to be talking about survival principles amid the crisis. Now, this is particularly to do with how you can survive during this time of crisis that the world is facing. We are facing as a business and as a country. We will also be So that's about what's going to be. We're going to be taking questions from you people. So if you guys have a question, please leave your questions in the comments for Kopi. Let's let you guys know what In the Spotlight is. In the Spotlight is basically a 1 hour session that we do every Friday, a live Instagram session that we do every Friday at around 7 o'clock. It's basically talk to one successful owner about different topics that we discuss on a week on week basis. For those who've joined us again and those who have been part of our journey that have been joining us over the weeks, thank you for being a part of this journey with us. Thank you for being a part of this session with us. I hope you guys were having a good time, and do leave your feedback and your comments to know how you guys are liking it. Or also, you could also let us know people that you want to listen to, speakers that you would want as a part of In the Spotlight. So today we have Gopi, business owner and organizational head of the Fortune Global organization. And we'll be talking to him about the survival principles of in the midst of crisis. So let's see if our guest is available and then we can bring him in. Okay, there he is.
Hi, Rohit.
Hi, Gopi. How are you?
Gopi, I'm good.
You would have to turn your laptop, this, your mobile.
Like this? You want me to turn?
This would be better.
This is okay? Yeah, now can better. I keep? I have to keep like this just a minute. This is not okay, right?
Yeah, this is perfect now.
This is perfect. Just a minute, I have to do my thing settings here. This is not okay. You don't like this.
No, actually the thing is the screen is sideways there. It's always on. So people have to look like this.
Okay. Done. No problem. So I can do like this.
Yeah.
Okay. Hi guys. Good evening, everyone. So thank you so much, Rohit, for inviting me. Okay. So yeah, hope everybody is doing great and everybody is safe. So am I visible to all the people?
Yes, you are visible and you are audible as well.
Okay, I'm visible, right? I'm audible as well, right? Okay. So well, guys, I'm just going to talk about the survival principles for entrepreneurs, okay, amid the crisis, okay? And the meaning itself says, okay, so what are the survival principles for the entrepreneurs? Okay. And so before I get into the topic, guys, okay. So first of all, I would like to congratulate all the people who've been selected for this call. So I am saying you've been selected, guys. It's not for everybody. And this is for the people, guys, who have, done with all their interview process, you understood, right? And, who played all the rounds, got selected. Okay. So we have not given the chance to the new people, I think. So only the people are doing well. Even the recently people got selected were given the opportunity. You understood. So I just would like to congratulate all of you people for getting selected in this call. Okay. So, well, okay. So, I mean, before I get into the topic, guys, just let me start my journey. You understood, right? So, yeah. So I think Rohit has already been introduced me that I am Gopi. This to all my organization team. So I did my BED to become a teacher, but eventually what I understood, only by becoming a teacher, so I cannot fulfill my dreams. So then I shifted, okay, so from getting into the government sector, so then thought of getting into the private sector, because as I know, in private sector, I can make good money. So yeah, so if I do good, I mean, performance with the private sector, then I can make more money. So in that perception, so I just joined in MBA. Okay, even during my BED and MBA, I was working for a couple of multinational companies. So after working for a couple of companies, so what I have understood is, even by being a private employee also, I cannot make more money. I understood that, because my financial growth is not in my control, and my career growth is not in my control. So most of the times, what I eventually found is, I'm not disrespecting, I'm not putting any other jobs down, but eventually what I found is, after working in, after going through the research about all the government jobs, after going, after personally working in private industry, what I come to know is, even government also, guys, you know, my salary is not decided by me, and my career growth or my financial growth is not decided by me. So my financial growth, you understood that, and my career growth is decided by the government. Even if I work in the private sector, okay, so my growth is decided by, okay, the management or the board directors and the stockholders. So if I, even if I do so well, even in private company, you understood that, okay, so I cannot demand more package from anyone. All I need to keep changing my companies. So eventually what I understood is, so yeah, so what I understood eventually is, by being only an entrepreneur, so we can make more money, okay, and we have huge financial freedom, and we have huge career freedom also, because I always believe in, okay, true decision making. So most of the times, you know, guys, our decisions are taken by our friends and relatives or family. They always impose that, okay, you should do this, you should do this, okay, you should join in this company, you should not do this job, okay. But I made decisions by myself to become an entrepreneur, because what I found is, eventually, is by only by being an entrepreneur, so we can make huge money. And yeah, so we can have huge career freedom and financial freedom. Okay, so yeah, so I was searching for so many opportunities. Okay, so after attending almost more than 175 interviews, okay, I just been selected in so many companies. Okay, even after attending so many companies, you know, even getting selected in most of the companies. Okay, and even I was asking to some of the HRs, okay, that, like, no, can my salary will be increased every year by this much percentage? And so they said, no, it's not possible. So they said, then I cannot work. Even there are few real estate sectors were offering me more. Okay, they said that you if you sell more plots, so we'll be giving more money. But even I asked them, like, no, can you make me chairman of, or can we make you, make me partner of one of your business? Then they said, it's not possible. You can grow only as an employee. So I was really looking for an entrepreneurship opportunity, because, okay, the reason why I joined in is MBA, because I've done my MBA with HR. The reason why I joined in MBA is to start my own company, but I didn't have any money to start the business, neither money nor experience. Because as you all know, to start a company, because yeah, everybody in this call, and even the graduates and postgraduates, everybody want to start their own business, but they don't have, either they don't have money or they don't have the experience. Okay. So, but eventually I found this opportunity wherein, without investing any money, you understood that, I got a job come entrepreneurship opportunity in the year of 2009, the same year I've done my MBA. So I joined here in 2009. Okay. And 2010, I got into the management. I became managing director for Fortune Global Organization. Okay. So when I joined in the company, people were under impression that, oh, it will take so much time. So people were telling me their opinions. Okay. And I found some people were leaving who could not do this thing. Okay. And people are failing in certain levels. They were also imposing their opinion on me. Gopi, it's not possible. You cannot grow here. Okay. But I proved everybody wrong. So eventually what I found is, okay, people were giving up at every level. Like, some people are giving in their first 5 days of training or first 1 week of training. And some people were giving up, okay, in the first one month, because when they're not coming through this, through score or performance or sales, they give up. And when somebody become a trainer, still people give up. People give up at leadership positions, people give up at assistant owner situation, and even few people may give up at the ownership situation also. Even after that also, guys, people give up. Okay, but what I found eventually, to become an entrepreneur, you understood that? So what I found is eventually, guys, you know, we have to take risk. The most important point, what I would like to tell you all people, even before I joined in this company, okay, there is a quotation saying that think 1,000 times before you take a decision, but after taking decision, don't give up even if you get 1,000 difficulties. I repeat it, guys, think 1,000 times before you take a decision, but don't give up, okay, even if you get 1,000 difficulties during your journey. So that's what I made the decision to become an entrepreneur, because I know here I don't need to invest any money. You understood that? I don't need to give anything to the company. So all I need to just learn the company's process, company's systems, and I've implement. So that's what I implemented. Okay. At every level I've implemented, then I became successful. At every level I've seen people are giving up, because I seen the people who trained me gave up, the people, okay. At leadership level, people gave up. But eventually what I learned from all those people are giving up is, okay, that, okay, they were not doing things properly, or they're not putting their efforts heartfully. Because I didn't find it is so difficult. You understood that? When I found it, I found this opportunity more easier than my previous jobs. Because in my previous jobs, I had to work more than 9 to 10 hours. You understood that? I have to work more than... So I, they're pressurizing me like anything. Thank God I don't have any of this pressure, because I have huge work freedom in this company. Because, you know, I come at certain time to the office, then I finish my training, then I go on field. Okay. Then I do my work. So you understood it. Sometimes I start my work by 11 o'clock. Then I finish my work by, initially I finish by 6 o'clock. But later on, guys, once I acquired skills, then I started finishing up my work by 3 o'clock. So because, see, the complete growth freedom or job freedom is in your control. You understood that? You can finish your work in 2 hours or 3 hours or 4 hours or 5 hours. It's up to all people. So there are no restrictions. People can complete their work in only 2 to 3 hours also. Initially, as I told you, I was taking more than 6 to 7 hours to finish my goal. But later on, once I understood the skills, okay, then I started finishing my work by 3 o'clock. I used to come back to the office by 4 o'clock. Then I used to started training and developing people. Once I became confident about sales, then I also understood that, okay, yes, I can replace people, because I found it easier. But initially I was finding it little challenging, especially, guys, you know, I always believe in this concept. In order to become something, okay, to become strong in some subject, when you're learning a bike or scooty, or whether you're doing new course, or you're leaving your parents and going abroad, first time you're going abroad, you're leaving parents, always I believe in a concept. There is a psychology says, for us to get adapted to the new situation, it will take 21 days. Okay. Whatever the thing that you're learning, whether you're learning car, whether you're learning flight, okay, you're learning bike or scooty, you cannot become strong in one single day. Okay. It's a 3 weeks process. It's a 21 days process. Okay. You don't like one dish or curry. Okay. So bitter gourd, let's take the example of bitter gourd. You keep eating it. You understood that? And then you will taste it, guys. You understood, right? So that's what I understood eventually, that yes, I have to take risk. Okay, so to be an entrepreneur, so we had to take risk, because I have already made up my mind. So whatever the challenges comes in my way, I decided to take those challenges, because I never found 1,000 difficulties. During my journey, I never found 1,000 difficulties. You understood that? I hardly found 13 difficulties from my BA to the ownership journey. Those difficulties, of those challenges, what I faced, okay, now what you feel people are facing, I face the same challenges. And even I got the answers for it. You understood, right? Not interested, busy, call me tomorrow. I'm already using it. How many times you people call me? Okay, kuch kaam dhande nahi aap logon ko, Hindi mein, like, you know, people say that kuch kaam dhande nahi aap logon ko, kyu call kar rahe bar bar. You understood, right? Okay, so in Telugu, the people, you know, like, you know, so in your respective languages, people know what objections. Only 13 objection. No, I am not interested. Busy. Call me tomorrow. I'm already using it. How can I trust you? Only this 12 to 13 objections. And you will feel any job challenging when you don't have the answers for these challenges. But already, guys, okay, there is a concept called as objection handling training. Already you have the answers for it also. You understood, right? When you have an answer, then why it's going to be challenging? You understood, right? Okay, when we read ourselves, okay, what are the subject during our 10th class or intermediate or degree or BTech or during MBA, sometimes we feel some subjects are challenging, but when you get a right teacher, right professor, and if he gives you the right solution, and the job is going to be easier, the task is going to be easier. And here, at every level, as a business associate, when you're dealing with sales, yes, you will face this objection, and we do have answers for it. All we just need to implement it. That's what I did in the first level. It took me little time. You understood that, okay? The out of all these levels, what I found is the most important level, the most challenging level I found it is sales. The sales is something like, you know, foundation, guys. It's like when you're constructing a house, okay, the basement and pillars takes more time. Hope everybody understood. So basement and pillars take more time. Yes, that has to be very strong. In order to run any business, you understood that, sales plays very important role. A teacher sale is knowledge to students. Sale. Again, sale is there. A doctor sale is knowledge. Okay. Is skills. Okay. Again, to the patients. You understood, right? What are the things that he'll learn? Okay. So he charges for his education. Okay. And everywhere except only one sale is free in the world is, guys, that is parents' love is free. Parents' affection is also sale. They sell their affection to the children. That is free. But apart from that, guys, everything, you understood, right? Which is involved with money. But guys, okay, in order to run any business, okay, now during this situation, there are so many business have been collapsed. Okay, but we are doing so well. The reason, guys, our foundations are very strong, our systems. So our business is designed, okay, developed with the systems. And that systems, if even 10th class people implement, okay, even uneducated people implement that law of average concept. Okay, law of average concept is very simple, guys. You understood that when you call 10 people, we know that there is 1 to 3 people only will respond. There are 6 to 7 people may respond, may not respond. So when you know that there are only law of average concept is working, then you don't need to worry about the sales. So if you implement the system that is law of average, 5 steps, 8 steps and impulse factors, there are certain systems. You understood that when you implement those systems and then you don't find it difficult. So what I found is eventually, guys, and I understood the systems. I started implementing. You understood that I seriously did law of average. You understood that initially my law of average was more than 150 customers because I didn't know the idea about the 5 steps. The reason why I was finding it difficult because I didn't know about introduction. I didn't know about an introduction. There is a C factor. I didn't know, but there is a short story. There is a gift factor. So initially I was doing so much hard work. That's why I was feeling difficult. Okay. Since I was not implementing the system in the first process. Okay. Then guys, I was not getting the results. So first 3 weeks, I found it little challenging. 3 to 4, almost 6 weeks, I found it little challenging. I was not cracking much deals. Okay. Even I found people who joined after me, they were really doing well. So I didn't know what I was going through. You understood? Because initially I joined in the company, guys, even I was doing the job with the doubts only. That's why, look, I could not crack much deals. But when I kept my doubts aside, okay, guys, I'm going to talk about the base foundation, okay, and the basement. Because if this is strong with you people, and then you can conquer, you can achieve the other levels in very short period. And even, okay, so if you become strong with the sales, you understood that? For any entrepreneur, you understood that? What does it matter is sales. Now, people, you understood that? Okay, people are selling sanitizer and mask. Okay, sale is very important, essential in our life. And most of the times when it comes to sales, we have a shame feeling and we have fear. And, you know, so sometimes, you know, we think that what others may think. You understood that here, especially in this business, okay, you have not chosen this company to do only sales throughout your life. You understood that here you have chosen this career, especially guys, to run your own company. While running, to run a company, your foundation is sales. So to get into that sales, I mean, to become strong in sales. Okay. So initially, guys, what I found is law of average. That law of average was meeting more people. But eventually, guys, okay, I started implementing the 5 steps theory. In my law of average, I was implementing my 5 steps theory. Then earlier, I was meeting 150 customers, okay, on the field. Now, like, you know, people who joined very recently, you may be doing more calls. But okay, so guys, I mean, we are doing more online now. So at this point of time, okay, with your calls, what are the calls? Even if you do 60 to 80 calls, if you implement 5 steps in that, okay, if your introduction is very perfect, if your giving your introduction with smile factor, because you may feel that customer, okay, whether he's listening to you or not, whether he's seeing your smile, but definitely, guys, okay, customer will feel your smile. Okay, so your introduction has to be with C factor, as I told you. You have to use smile factor. You have to use eye contact. You cannot maintain the eye contact over the phone, but you can still be excited when you're making the call. It's not about how many calls you make in a during a day, guys. It's all about, okay, how many effective calls you make, how many customers are impressed, how many people are liked your movie. You understood, right? Okay, when you're a director, there are some directors that keep taking movies. Every year they take 10, they direct 10 movies. What is the use of directing 10 movies? In Telugu, like, you know, Tollywood guys, there is a Rajamouli. You understood, right? You take example. He direct only few movies, but all are blockbusters. But what a lot of conviction and lot of dedication. You understood, right? Even when in order to get a sales, it's not about making more calls. It's all about how many calls you are making it effectively. So law of average with five steps theory. Your introduction has to be with C factor. Your short story has to be with gifts factor. I'm telling you guys, this five steps is like a smart work. When you use five steps, okay, in your law of average, and I'm telling you guys, you will get results. You don't need to do too much hard work and you will get results. So for you to make your foundation very strong, the sales is your foundation. You have to use law of average theory and you have to use compulsory five steps in your law of average. And there is one more factor, then the student called as eight steps theory. Okay, you can ask your respective managers, what are the eight steps? In eight steps, I will discuss about only one step that I always believe in, that always maintaining positive mental attitude. Whatever the situation you go through during your journey, your life journey, always maintain positive attitude. Always maintain positive attitude. You will go through financial problem. You will go through a personal problem. You will go through a family problem. For all problem, only the solution is money, guys. Only solution is money. To get money, you have to make your sales better. To make your sales better, okay, you need to carry two things always in your mind. Whether it is sales, whether it is team building, whether it is managing small team, whether it is managing big team, whether it is managing small company or big company or organization, there are always two things you have to follow, guys. One is your mentality, and second thing, your mechanics. Your mentality has to be very strong. You understood that your mindset has to be very strong, okay? And your mechanics, you need to implement the right mechanics. So you need to understand, to get sales, as I told you, you have to use law of average, five steps theory, okay? And you have to use impulse factors. As I told you guys, you know, in introduction, you have to use C factor. In short story, you have to use gifts factor. In presentation, you have to use kiss and kill factor. You have to make presentation short and simple. That is called as keep it short and simple. You have to know direct and indirect closing, and you have to use the rehash theory, reference theory. Now, at this point of time, during this corona time, the references will work like anything, guys. Even you put a lot of effort to close a one deal, or you may be having existing customer data, just call those customers. Even personally, guys, I utilize those existing customers. Even whatever the sales I have done during this time, I used to call, because I used to take care of my organization, interviews, office and everything. I get hardly 1 or 2 hours, or maximum 3 to 4 hours sometimes. So even I make calls. During that point of time, I close some deals with law of average and with five steps. And whatever the deals I close, I take references. Okay, I take references not like a salesperson. I take references, sir, like, you know, you can refer, because it's a referral offer we are giving. So you can refer three of your friends or three of your families. That way, like, you know, I use the reference theory perfectly. So guys, using your law of average and your five steps and impulse factor, that's where, guys, you know, if you use these three things along with that, okay, these are sales techniques. Okay, these are sales techniques, okay, you have to use to make your sales better, okay, and then while doing it, guys, okay, there is a mentality process, there's a mindset process here, is eight steps theory. So you have to, guys, literally I've did research on five steps and law of average and eight steps. Okay, we don't need your MBA here, let me tell you guys, whatever the qualification you have, if you do research on these systems, okay, you will do well. You understood, right? You will really do well when you have complete grip about all these systems. Law of average, five steps, okay, and impulse factor. These are your techniques to do sales, and eight steps. In eight steps, only the first step is, okay, having positive mental attitude. When you maintain positive mental attitude, sometimes you go through downs. Okay, you don't get sales. You do calls, you don't get sales. Okay, you'll give up. You feel that this sales job, I can't do sales. You make 30 calls, 40 calls, 50 calls, 60 calls, and you'll give up. But guys, you never analyze that, okay, the calls that you're making, You never analyze whether you are using, because see, always remember guys, when somebody is saying not interested, it means there are only two reasons customer will say not interested. Guys, I'll talk more about the sales guys, because this is foundation. Okay, this is foundation. If this is sorted out, then guys, your other things will get easily sorted out. I'm telling you guys, in this company, what I've learned the most is I became champion. I became so better in the sales. And let me tell you guys, it took me a little time to become strong in sales. But once I become strong in sales, it took me only 5 months to get into manager promotion. So all I became first became strong in the sales by using all these things. Okay. Yeah. As I was telling you all people guys. Okay. So once you become strong. Okay. Yeah. So as I was telling, okay, that if your customer is saying not interested, or customer says, okay, there are two reasons customer will say not interested. One, when you are doing calls without any interest, you understood, right? When you are not doing calls without interest, you may be doing calls by the force of manager or force of your leader. Sometimes you do namke vasta calls. You understood, right? Time pass calls. You don't do it effective introduction. That's how customers say not interested. That is one reason. You understood, right? Or maybe you're not using your introduction with C factor. You're not excited. Okay. You're not using the right introduction to the customer. That's how customer will say not interested. Okay. There are only two objections that we get, major objection, not interested. Okay. Or we say call back. Why customer is saying call back? Okay. You're not giving strong fear of loss. You're not showing him the benefits that if you buy today, like, you know, what are the savings that you're going to do? You understood that? So when you don't use all these things in your closing, you understood closing techniques, if you don't keep it properly. Okay, guys, your sales becomes okay dull. So all you need to just get good with this systems, guys. Do research on the systems. Thoroughly follow the systems. Every 1 hour, do review for yourself. Do self introspection. Okay, then that's where, like, you know, guys. Okay, you become strong in the sales. And now at this point of time, do start recording your presentation and send it to the performers and ask them. Okay, ask them to check your pitch. Okay, so that they will tell you what exactly you guys are missing it. Yesterday I was checking one of my new girl. She's 2 days old in the company. She's saying, sir, are you interested? Are you interested to buy this product? And no customer, when you say no customer is going to say that I am interested to buy the product. So guys, when you send your presentation to the performers, or when you do the networking, the second point, apart from learning these things, guys, do networking. This is what the point I want to tell you guys. Do networking. What I did is in this company is, guys, initially I did networking with two people to become my sales stronger. I started every day, started doing networking with the people who are doing sales, good sales every day, who are doing good performance. Even I started going on field with one of the person who is only done intermediate. He was doing only his graduation. Okay. In distance, he was doing his correspondence degree. Okay. I done my MBA. So when I told him, Manish, I will come with you for retraining. And he literally told me, okay, so brother, like, you know, your MBA, I am only graduate. How you can come with me? I said, I don't have any shame. I don't have any shame in learning from you. So like I went and learned from him. What I learned from him is he was giving very short presentation with a lot of excitement, and he was doing qualifying presentation. So then I picked that. Then I started high rolling from the next day. Even I learned from my guy who's an organization head. Okay. So Anumanta, okay, he was doing so better than me. He joined under my team. Even I learned from my guys. As I told you, I don't have any learning mentor. I mean, don't have any problem in learning from people who are doing well. So I started learning from the people who are doing well with the sales. So I got good with the sales. And the second thing, guys, I learned the recruitment part. Then I started getting along with it, because in our company, there are only two things, okay, plays very crucial role. One is sales and recruitment. First, get good with the sales. Okay. Start networking with all the people who are really doing well every single day. Okay. Now I suggest you guys, you don't need to, I mean, you can watch movies, you can enjoy all these things, but at this point of time or any time, get along with only two people in our business. One is people are continuously doing good sales, and people are doing good sales plus good with good recruitments. So that's what you have to get good with, sales and recruitment. When you get good with these two things, because, okay, the other thing is, guys, okay, you have to think about your financial situation also, guys. Every month, okay, you need to make money. Okay, it's not only, guys, you know, sometimes we don't have targets here, and, you know, we just take it for granted. You understood that? We take it for granted. Chalo, aaj nahi to kal karunga. Main kal karu to, you know, I'll do it after few days. You understood that? Do not procrastinate, guys. Try to maintain performance on consistent basis. So 2009, my face value was every day it was 1,000 rupees. 2009 when I joined the company, because I kept my face value as 30,000 rupees. Now your face value every day should be, guys, minimum 1,500 to 2,000 rupees. and you work for it, whichever the client you are dealing with, charity or entertainment division or insurance division or any division, you have your face value, guys. Because I'll just give you a simple example, guys. When you're acting in a movie, which role you would like to take? You would like to take a free role wherein people act in movie for free of cost. I mean, they don't take money. Just they want to show, you understood it? They want to show themselves in the movie. Okay, Rohit, can you hear me? Can you all understand what I'm saying, Rohit? Yeah, so when you're acting in a movie, so you want to be a free, you want to act in a free role, or you want to act in the 300, 500 rupees role, okay, or you want to act in the 1,000 rupees role. 1,000 is a character, I mean, hero, a hero, hero and friend. You understood that? The 2,000 rupees, okay, is your the main lead role. Okay, but to get into that lead role, and you have to be a performer, guys. And your face value should be 2,000 per day now at this point of time. And you just need to calculate, okay, what is the performance you have to do to make 2,000? Okay, making 2,000 is easier. All you just need to keep your mindset, because 2009, 10 years back, 1,000 was okay for me. Now you require 2,000 rupees. I know, guys, you may stay at home now at this point of time. Okay, you may not have much expenses, but always, guys, when you have money in your pocket, that will give you a lot of confidence. You understood that? Your face value is 2,000 rupees per day. To make 2,000 rupees, I told you, just all you need to implement the systems effectively. Do networking with the people who are doing good sales. Once you get good with sales, making money, okay, it's always have a mindset of giving. In 60,000, I have to give at least 30,000 rupees to my family. 10,000 is for my expenses, okay? And 20,000 rupees need to be a savings. Let your family feel proud about you, guys. During this pandemic situation, my son is making 30,000 rupees. My daughter is making this much money. So that's how, guys, you have to get good with strong in sales. Okay, then once you become strong in sales and once you become consistent in sales, then guys, definitely, okay, the recruitment becomes more easier, because you can easily recruit people, guys. Recruitment is damn easy in our business if you are good in sales. Okay, because when you are good in sales, you are showing people that making money is easier. See, everywhere money making is important, guys. Everywhere money plays very important role. All situations, okay, the problem, okay, you understood, all the problems are solved by money. For all problems, money is the solution. Make money. When you make everyday money, or when you make every week, you may make money, and the people who join under you, guys, they'll also get a belief, and you can also give them solutions. And that's what I did, guys, during this pandemic, this corona situation. I didn't sit, you understood that, immediately, okay, I transformed. Okay, earlier we were doing, going on field and doing all these things. So immediately, guys, you know, so because everybody was thinking that what's going to happen, so we didn't wait for it. You understood that? We just started calling people, and then I found it, okay, literally, guys, I found it is easier than going on the field. You understood that? Because we get a lot of time. Okay, because, you know, so guys, we go to office by 7:30, 8 o'clock, we do pitch practice till 10, 10:30, we go on field. There is a lot of time is getting wasted in traveling and morning meeting and everything, guys. Now here, at this situation, you all can sleep till 8 o'clock, till 7 o'clock. Okay, guys, you get sufficient time to do lot many calls. And when you have face-to-face rejection, sometimes we take it personally. But when customer says something over the phone, guys, you have an option to cut the phone, okay? And you can immediately, guys, go for the next call. Understood that? I found it is easier than the previous process. So then, guys, first 3 days, even I didn't get the thing. I didn't get any score. But I didn't give up on the calls. I truly believe in the law of average. This is what... Okay, first day I didn't get score. When we started first time telecalling, second day no score. Third day I got result after 10 o'clock. Okay, customer himself called me and he made the payment. Because that customer, morning he was listening to me, and afternoon is one of his relatives admitted in the hospital, and they were discussing about importance of this product. Okay, and he called me. Okay, I already sent him the payment link and everything. And he called me around 9:40, and he sent me, he did his payment. That is my first deal. And when I did my second deal, I already slept. I discussed with the customer, and around, guys, 11:30, 10:45, so I was about to, I slept almost. I kept my phone aside, and customer, okay, send me the payment screenshot. So that's how, guys, you know, okay. So I started getting the results. So what I'm telling you, guys, okay, first of all, you have to get good with this process in sales, and then next levels are going to be very easier. So once I became strong with the sales, then I started building team. As I told you guys, I just got promoted into an assistant manager level only in 2 months. Once my sales were perfect, I became assistant manager in 2 months. And from there, I took only 3 months to become manager. Okay. So initially I took little time. So that's what I did, guys. And I joined in this company when there was a global recession. Okay. When there was a global recession and I joined in a product wherein everybody was giving up on this product. I joined in Reliance Big TV product. Everybody was finding it difficult to sell it because, okay, that time cable, it was 25, 30 rupees, 50 rupees, wherein we were selling it for 200, 300 rupees per month connection. Okay, I mean the monthly charges. But guys, I deliberately started doing that product. I started doing well that product. And the other challenge, guys, everybody was doing great in road trips. Okay, I mean they're going in out stations and they're doing good, but I deliberately started doing better. The point what I'm trying to tell you guys, okay, yes, if you want to be an entrepreneur, entrepreneur have to take the risk. You understood that, okay? And you have to be all the challenges. And I think you all know the example of Sonu Sood, guys. Now he is known to everybody in the country because he is standing against people. I don't know what is his intention, but yes, everybody remember him, guys. Now he has become the real hero. So now, guys, okay, so after Corona, everybody can perform. That's nowhere you will get a respect. But when these situations come, when, okay, so when you become an entrepreneur, guys, people become entrepreneur who face all these crises, who accept all these challenges. You understood, right? So that's what I wanted to say, guys. Okay, so yes, the foundation, the basement, if you become strong, the other levels become very, you can conquer it in very short period. So once I got a belief, then I started teaching. Even my team, when they found it, okay, the people who started in my team, okay, they were doing greater sales than me. Okay, and they got a belief that array when Gopi is doing it, because Gopi learned sales from us. Okay, now he's managing sales and recruitment. When he can get promoted, even my success has become, you know, guys, okay, what we say, guys, you know, good, what we say, vision to all the people. Like they got a belief that when Gopi can become owner, when Gopi can become manager, and you know, they also found it easier. Array, he's become manager. Okay, then everybody got that idea and they started implementing. Then I've been training my people on the same thing, guys. Okay, so for you to be an entrepreneur, one, okay, so guys, if you have pen and paper, I'll just make it fast, then we can have question and answer. Rohit, how much time we have? I think I've passed 20 minutes.
Minutes, so we can get into the question answers then. 20 minutes.
Yeah, 20 minutes. Already, I just, you know, whatever the things they have, Rohit, I've already cleared. I don't think so they will have more question. You can see this because I've cleared their question because all their questions, okay, is only because once they good with sales, get good with sales, they don't have any questions.
Yeah.
Just they have to do laugh average. Now earlier it was field laugh average. Now it is only over the phone laugh average. Laugh average, effective 5 steps. Okay. Impulse factor and 8 steps. Systems, if they use it properly, okay, they have the solutions in that systems only. You understood, right? Okay. So the answer is there in the book itself only. You don't need to go anywhere. The answers are there in the systems itself only. All you need to get with the systems. Okay, once you get good with the system, then you can implement same systems. You can train. First, you implement the systems and make money and you train people. Okay, and you teach people to implement the systems and teach people to make money. That's how, guys, you will build a team. So that's what I wanted. That's how, guys, I build a bigger organization. So today I'm across, you know, almost we have 16 to 17 branches. So guys, we are expanding and we are going to open more offices across the country. Okay, now I found it more easier, the telecalling. But there are a few points I would like to discuss, guys. Okay, I already covered so many things. Okay, so yeah, in order to be an entrepreneur, as I told you guys, one, you, because the difference between employee and entrepreneur is, guys, only an entrepreneur, they always take risk. If you want to be an entrepreneur, take risk. At every level, you will face challenges. Just every challenge has got an answer, guys. As I told you, especially in our business, every challenge has got an answer. Every problem has got a solution. Okay, first of all, be ready for the challenges. Okay, be ready to take risk, because most of the times, employees, okay, the people who give up, there is a quotation, there is a saying that, okay, 97% of the employees are ruled by 3% of the entrepreneurs. Or 3% of the entrepreneurs are ruled by 97%. I mean, they rule the 97% of the employees. A difference between an employee and entrepreneur is entrepreneur take risk. They take risk. You have to take risk. Okay? Take positive risk, because here it is not at all risk. Risk is something when you don't know it. When you don't know, you understand? When you don't know how to drive a car, That's a risk. But here, somebody is teaching you how to drive a car. Initially, they're teaching you everything about car and everything, and somebody sitting beside you are in a bike and they're teaching you, then it's not going to be a risk. Especially in our company, it's not at all a risk. Okay, that is one point. The second point, guys, okay, so need to be ready for all the challenges. That's most important thing. So be ready for all the challenges. Every problem has got solution. And the third point, okay, I would like to tell guys, okay, so you have to keep your fear and shame aside. Whatever the process you are doing, definitely, guys, your family, for entrepreneurs, let me tell you guys, when somebody is becoming hero, there will be more people, they will try to pull you down. And when you try to become an entrepreneur, so many people will doubt you, and you doubt so many times. Just keep that doubt aside and keep those people aside, guys. You understood, right? The other thing, okay, so networking is most important thing. As I told you, network with people who are doing good sales. Okay, first get good with the sales. Keep doing networking till you get the momentum with sales, and keep doing networking with people who are building team. So that is till you become manager. Once you get good with sales and recruitment, then think about organization building. That also becomes more easier, guys. If you get good with sales and recruitment, organization building is so easier, guys. So networking is most important thing. Network in our business, network with social media, okay? Like, go through Instagram page, like, know that this is kind of networking now, because I listen to all the the speakers who have done before me. I've listened to all the speakers. I wrote down all the points. Even I implement. Last week I learned from Amit Baid. Previous week I learned from Lyric. Okay, Melvin, Nadim, all the people. You understood that, guys? Okay, Krishna Chaitanya. I learned from all the people. I took down the points. Okay, I implemented in my daily life. There are few points. Okay. So networking is most important thing. Okay. So the other thing is, guys, learning mentality. So learn from people. Understood that? Okay, that's the next point. I just wrote it down. So yeah, so just have patience, you guys, because here don't expect result immediately. Just believe in the system. Believe in the system. As I told you guys, on third day I got my result, and fourth day I got result around 11 o'clock. So just believe in the system and don't lose hope when you're not getting the result. Just when you are going through challenges, just talk to people who are doing well, and you'll definitely get a solution. And the other thing is, guys, okay, and most important thing, guys, you have to be really fit and give priority. Last time, like Lyric Agarwal told, give priority to your fitness, guys. Give time. Health is wealth. That's most important thing. Eat right food, sleep well. You understood that? And do exercise, do yoga, do meditation, at least 10 15 minutes. Do any kind of exercise, guys, that keeps you fit. And during your work, take frequent break. That's most important thing. Every 1 hour, take 5 10 minutes break. Just do sky walking. You understood that? Just look at sky. Or if you're in the room, just do walk. You understood that? So take sometimes inhale, exhale, long inhale and long exhale. So that keeps you fit. Okay. So yoga and meditation and exercise. Okay. So fitness and eating right food is most important thing. Okay. Do not eat much oil food, puri and bhajia and all these things, because we are into calling. Okay. Sometimes that makes you lazy, guys. Eat the right food, because it's been 10 years I eat only idli in my breakfast. Maximum times I eat idli and fruits. You understood that? Because the breakfast which I hate most is idli, but still I eat only idli. So that keeps me, guys, morning time, that keeps me more excited. Okay, I do not touch much oil food. The last other thing I would like to tell you guys, stay away from the negative situations. Like, you will, during your challenges, as I told you guys, there are many people will pull you down. Okay, that may be in the friends of your friends or your former friends, your family, relatives, society and colleagues. Okay, for you, nobody is important except your family. So just educate your family about the opportunity and tell them that, okay, ask them time, 1 or 2 years time, and just keep putting efforts, guys. Okay, and the other thing is, guys, have mentors. You understood? Like for me, I have Tony and Kishore. Okay, because for me, guys, my trainer left, my leader left, my assistant owner left during the process. But guys, okay, so initially I was self-motivated, but during the process, guys, I also identified the mentors. I was continuously in touch with the mentors. And the last thing is, guys, okay, enjoy your process. The more you enjoy, you understood that? That's what I told you. Initially I was working 8 hours, 9 hours. Okay, I was working like a donkey, hard work. Then eventually I started doing smart work, that was giving 2 to 3 effective presentation per hour instead of doing more calls. Okay, doing less calls but giving effective presentation. Happy presentation, happy presentation. Customer should connect to your presentation. It's not about, guys, test match. It's 1 day. You understood that? Okay, make audience more attentive and more attractive. So that's what, these are the points I would like to tell you. Okay, so that's it from my side, Rohit. I think in case we have 10 minutes time, Let's
Yeah.
have. I think people will not have questions
Happy
after this thing.
to answer. One is from Henny who says, how do you take reference? P. Henny is a regular question asker in our sessions. So Henny would like to know how do you take reference?
Guys, this is most important aspect in the sales industry. So write down this point, guys. One satisfied customer is the best advertiser. Okay, so I know, guys, to sign one customer, you will take lot of, you will put lot of efforts. Okay, but the once the customer is signed, okay, you understand what means your movie is hit. Your movie is hit, and you can ask customers. You can happily ask the customer. Sir, like, you know, so since you have already got selected in a product, so with there is a reference offer we are giving, sir. Okay, with you we can give 3 or 5 or 10 customers. Okay, because the product which I am giving you, it is more beneficial. What are the product you are doing? Because he know, because sometimes, guys, you know, you might have taken 30 minutes, 40 minutes time to convince one customer, but okay, to convince his friends and his relatives and his known people, it won't take much time, guys. Because let me tell you, at this point of time, especially during this corona, I did proper hard work for 1 or 2 months, and after that, guys, I started calling. So apart from the half average that I was doing, I started calling those people, okay, whom I signed. Even they themselves, they are calling me, guys. They are making me so busy in filling the forms. Now sometimes they are only filling the forms, Gopi. They are only giving the presentation. So first you give good presentation, guys. It's like, you know, mango tree, as I told you, apple tree. There are some trees will give you fruits all the time, apple, but to get that, to grow that apple tree, okay, you require a lot of patience. You understood that? You need to take care of that tree properly, guys. Similarly, you just need to take care of yourself and your mindset. Okay, give proper efforts, and once you sign the deals, okay, you may have your own customers, or during the process you may have some existing customers. Okay, yes, during the laugh average, guys, you will find our I was showing the references, sir. My pitch is very simple. I always use two things in my pitch. Okay, I always use two things. One is sheep factor and reference. Sir, I already spoke to XYZ person in your area. I will speak to you for 2 minutes. So when I say the XYZ person in area in that area, the other people will show interest to talk to me. Okay, so I choose sector wise. I choose area wise. I call that data. So I say, suppose if I am calling in Bombay, as I told you guys, okay, I take Malad, or I take Bandra. In Bandra, I spoke to one medical shop. I say, sir, I already spoke to Rohit Medicals in Bandra. I will speak to you for 5 minutes. So he allow me to talk to him. That makes my easier, so my work so easier to give presentation. And the other thing, when I close him, you understood what I use is, okay, name to the so many people, sir. Already we given to XYZ people, and sir, we will also, okay, if you get selected, we will also give you the offer. And once that is done, then I'll keep taking references from those area and those customers only. Hope I answered your question, guys.
Okay, so we have a question from Rahul who says, what is the one thing which has changed as a person from owner to organization head?
What I implement, okay, from owner to organization head. So far, guys, you know, I'm very disciplined, and I have a schedule first of all. What I did, okay, what time I was waking up as a BA, now I wake up at same time. I know that I get more time now, you understood that, but still, okay, so what I am implemented as a trainer, I don't think so that I'm an arguer or I'm an owner. I just work like a trainer, guys. That's what, like, what I was initially, I was the best trainer. That's how I replaced so many people, and still I want to be the best trainer. So I have to be the trainer, guys. I have to be the coach. I have to be the best coach. Understood that? Okay, I cannot give solutions by reading books. Okay, I cannot give other people things. I want to be a solution provider to my people. Okay, for that I will involve first. I started doing the calls, then I started giving the solution. So yeah, so I mean, so the am I answered the thing, the question, Rahul, Rohit?
So
you have
I think
to be the best trainer.
We can take one last question. This is from Preeti. I'm sure you can read
yeah.
this.
Good evening, sir. What frequent questions or points you ask customers to connect a customer to you? Good evening, sir. Okay, what frequent questions or points you ask? I didn't understand the question. Okay, just a minute. Yeah, I'll just relate with the current examples, guys. I don't call people whenever I call. I don't call people to buy a product. You understood? I just call people and I suggest them. That's it. I just suggest them the whatever the product we are giving. If you are doing charity, you understood it. Suggest them the importance of the charity at this point of time. Like, you know, so they are helping somebody. You understood that? Okay. So I mean, that gives them a lot of satisfaction. And if you are dealing with entertainment product, then just, you know, you are saving people time. And the people money you're saving. A product, guys, rather make customer to realize, just let them feel that, you know, what they lose if they don't take this product. Understood that? Okay, so you have to create that kind of scenario to the people. So just call as if you are not a from salesperson. Just okay, think that you are a god. You are giving something to them because it is which is very important. Just make them more, make them understand the value of this product. Just all we need to make people to realize about the product, because whenever I call, I don't expect any sale. Guys, sale is not in my hand. But what is in my hand is presentation. I only truly believe in 3 to 5 qualifying presentation. Understood that? I believe in only presentation, and I give proper presentation. My presentation is like a movie. People need to get connected to movie. So I'll give all the examples. It's not that, you know, I just make it very fast, but even if I do it fast also, so people get connected to the presentation. It's like documentary. It's like a trailer. You don't need to give total pres. I never give my total presentation, total benefits to the customers, guys. Because short story is such, it's something like you have to explain the product in very short way. Okay, so introduction, short story. That's where, like, you know, we close the deal. Introduction, short story, only the deal will close. That's why your introduction has to be with C factor and your short story has to be with gifts factor. There should be agreed that what is the thing that you're giving to the customer? What is the best product? What is the offer that you're giving? There should be an indifference. Like, you know, you have to make, sir, this is not for everybody. This is for only few people. Okay, there should be fear of loss, sir. Okay, this is only today. There should be a tone of voice. You should use your tone in bigger way. So when you're calling, you just make yourself special. Make customer special. You understood that? And the other thing is, okay, so there should be a proper what we say, a she factor. Like, you know, you just use some example that I've already spoke to some XYZ person. So when you use this, you understood that, and people will definitely get connected. Don't call to the people in the you know, by expecting a sale. Sale is not in our hand, guys. Only presentation are in our hand. So give effective presentation, but that presentation should be like a movie. Okay, wherein customers should get connected. Any other questions, Rohit? I think I've taken more time.
I think that's about it. I think that should do. I think you've answered all the questions. I think everybody's had a good session today. So thank you so much for joining us. Thank you so much for your time. And thank you so much for speaking to the audience. We really appreciate your time and effort for this.
Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you so much, Rohit. Okay, so guys, all the best, everyone. Okay, just emerge as a COVID warrior or a COVID entrepreneur. Because at this point of time, if you do well, okay, so everybody will recognize you. If you do well in normal time, nobody is going to look at you, guys. But if you do well at this point of time, and you'll become popular, like Sonu Sood. You understood that? Okay, in Hollywood and in India, he has become most popular now. You understood that in our business or in your village, in your hometown or in your state, okay, just, you know, guys, do something extra than everybody at this point of time and put little more efforts and become more famous and become an inspirational personality to so many people, guys. Thank you so much, everyone. Okay, so all the best. Okay, good night, everyone. Take care of yourself and your family and your known people and unknown people. Thank you so much, guys. Bye. Bye, everyone.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thank you all.
All right. Thank you so much, people, for joining us. I hope you guys had a great session. And hopefully Gopi was able to answer all your questions. And I'm sure you guys have a lot to take back from the session. All right. It was great having you guys being a part of the show. We will see you next week. Till then, please take care of yourself. Be safe and, you know, be healthy. Don't forget to join. Don't forget to like and follow the Fortune Global Organization. For those who have joined us for the first time, thank you so much. Those who are going to be joining us and those who have been a part of our journey. Thank you so much for being with us again this evening. We'll see you next week. Stay tuned to our page. We've got some great speakers lined up in the coming weeks. Both organization heads and business owners of very successful companies that have been been a part that have been part of the business for more than a decade. They've been in the business for more than a decade. So till then, thanks. Take care. Be safe. And good night. I'll see you next week. Stay tuned to our page to know who the next speaker is. Bye, guys.